Hello, this is B.V. Ramana, teacher in English. In this video, I would like to share with you the topic, how to make questions, part 2, with the WH word, who. Now, the first question, what is who? Who is an interrogative pronoun? And second question, where to use who? Who can be used for persons in two cases, that is, for persons in the subject place and for the persons in the complement places. And also, the mixing case will be there where in the sentences we can have the persons both in subject place and complement places. Let us see all these three cases with some examples.
Well, the case number one. Here, we can find the persons in the subject places. It will be very easy for us to make a WH word question, that is with who in these cases. That means simply the persons in the subject place can be removed and in that place we can write who. Then our required answer will be ready. That means here the verb cannot be changed into interrogative form even if it is in question form. So, Ramu lives in Srikakulam is the question. Here, Ramu is the person which is in the subject place. So, Ramu is removed and in the place who is written. Then, we get the answer, who lives in Srikakulam. Here, the verb lives is not changed into interrogative form. And example number two, Raju and Ravi are playing. Here, the phrase Raju and Ravi refers to persons which is in the subject place. So, our task will be very, very easy. That means, this phrase the phrase which refers to the persons can be removed and in that place we can make use of who. Here, the verb need not be in interrogative form. So, directly we can make use of who in the place of subject. So, we get the answer, who are playing will be the answer.
Well, friends, now you have seen how we can make a question using who. So, in the first case, you have seen that whenever we have that persons in the subject place, we can easily make a question with who. That means that who, that the phrase or the word referring to a person can be removed from the subject place and there we can make use of who in that place. Then our answer will be ready. Now let us see what is the second case.
Here is the case number two. Here, who can be used for persons in the complement places. Complement places means if the person is found after B form, it is called complement places. Let us see how to do the question with who. Example number one. This is Raju. Here, Raju is in the complement place. Here, we cannot directly make use of who. First, we have to convert this sentence into yes or no question. This will be the first step. So, here, this is Raju becomes is this Raju question mark. Here, we have made an yes or no question. And then, by removing this person in the complement, we can write who at the beginning of this sentence. Then, we will get the required answer. Here, the answer is, who is this?
So, you might have seen in the second case, that is, if a person is found in the complement place, we have to change the sentence into yes or no question and then removing that person in the complement, we have to write who at the beginning of this sentence. Thereby, we can get our required answer. Well, let us see what is the case number three.
Well, here is the case number three. Here, who can be used for persons both in subject and complement places. That means sometimes we come across the sentences where we can find the persons both in subject and complement places. Then we can have the two answers. One answer is meant for subject and another answer is for persons in the complement places. Let us see with some example. Example number one. Mohan is my brother. Here there are two persons in the subject place and in the complement place. Here Mohan is in the subject place. So here we can easily make a question with who. That means the Mohan can be removed and in that place we can write who. Then we get the required answer, that is, who is your brother? And now the question of my brother. Whenever we want to change this my brother for who, then we need to make a little bit exercise. You know already that we have done in the case number two. What is that? Look at this one. Mohan is my brother. Here we want to write who for this my brother. And then we have to make the sentence into yes or no question. That means here the verb takes the form of interrogative form. So is Mohan your brother will be the yes or no question. This must be changed first. And then your brother can be removed and we can make use of who at the beginning of this sentence. Then we will get the required answer. Look at this example number two. She must be Miss Mary. Here she is the person in the subject and Miss Mary is the person in the complement. So we can have the two answers for using who. That means one answer is meant for the person in the subject and another answer is meant for the person in the complement. Answer one. So whenever we want to use who for the subject, we have to remove this person in the subject place and there we have to write who. Then we will get the answer, who must be Miss Mary? Question mark. And answer two is meant for who for this person in the complement place. Let us see. She must be Miss Mary. And we here, we cannot write directly who at the beginning of this sentence. First, we have to change this sentence into yes or no question. That means the verb should be in interrogative form. So, must she be Miss Mary will be the first step. And then Miss Mary, the person in the complement, can be removed and we can make use of who at the beginning of this sentence. Then we will get the required answer, that is, who must she be? Well,
you might have seen in the case number three, that is, whenever we have in the sentences two persons in subject place and in complement place, we have the two answers. Let us see, let us have some more practice with some examples.
Well, this is the exercise. Number one, Ramya can sing songs. This is the question of case one. That means the person is found in subject place. So here Ramya is removed from the subject place and there we can make use of who. So the required answer will be who can sing songs. Next, number two, Mr. Ramesh was her doctor. This is the case number three. That means this is the sentence where we can have the persons both in subject place and complement place. That means here we can get the two answers. One answer is for subject and the answer is for complement. For subject answer, it is quite easy. Just we have to remove this Mr. Ramesh from the subject place and we have to write who there. Then our required answer will be who was her doctor. And now for second answer, we have to change the verb into interrogative form. So let us see how it is happened. Mr. Ramesh was her doctor. Here, first we have to change this one into yes or no question. That means, was Mr. Ramesh her doctor will be the first step. And then her doctor is to be removed and who can be written at the beginning of the sentence. Let us see next example. Mr. Ramesh was a doctor. Here it is a case 1. You might be amazed to see this explanation, because here doctor seems to be a person, but here doctor refers to a profession. So this is the case number 1. That means we can only make use of that who for making question only with the person in the subject. We cannot make use of who for the person in the complement place. Look at this one. Mr. Ramesh was a doctor. Here the first answer is, by removing this Mr. Ramesh, we can write who in that place. So we get the answer, who was a doctor here. Then here the for person a doctor, we cannot make use of who, because it refers to a profession. So for profession we have to make use of only what. So the answer will be little bit different. That means Ramesh was a doctor here. Here it refers, doctor refers to profession. Now we have to make use of first step, we have to make this one into an yes or no question. That means, was Mr. Ramesh a doctor here will be the yes or no question. And then we have to remove a doctor, and instead of writing who at the beginning of the sentence, we have written here what. So what was Mr. Ramesh here will be the right answer. And next one, example number 4. Madhumati teaches English well. Here this is a case number 1, because only one person is there in the subject. It is very 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 easy, you know, that this person in the subject place is to be removed, and there we have to write who. Then we will get the answer, who teaches English well. And next example, this is John. Here it is a case number 2. That means we find the person in the complement place. So for this one, we have to change first as a first step into a yes or no question. So is this John will be changed first as a first step. And then John is to be removed, and who can be kept at the beginning of the sentence. And then we got the answer, who is this. In this way, we can make questions using WH word who.
So we have used who for persons in 3 cases. One is for the persons in the subject place, for the persons in the complement place, and for the persons both in subject place and complement places. You may have one question. What about whom and how it is differentiated? Can't we make use of who for the persons in the object place? Let us have an explanation about this one in the next video. Thank you, friends. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel by tapping subscribe button on YouTube. Thank you very much. Namaste.